Hey guys, it's Danny. Welcome to another episode from our Orchid Care for Beginners series. Today I have yet another very, very interesting topic for you. We're going to be talking about the most common instances or signs which let you know it is definitely time to repot your orchid. So I will start with these instances, but towards the end of the video, I will also give you a few notes on repotting in general and also answer a few very common questions that you guys left in the comments section of my videos. Today's video, together with our entire Orchid Care for Beginners series, is sponsored by repotme.com, who offers you everything you could possibly need to properly take care of your orchid, from potting mixes to pots, fertilizers, accessories, and much, much more. If you're into bonsais, African violets, and succulents, they do have something for you as well, so I'll be sure to link you to their website down below in the description. Feel free to visit them at any time, and I will also be linking you my absolute favorite products that I keep using all the time in my grow room. Right, so with that said, let's just start with, I believe, the most common instance that tells you it is time to do that repot. First of all, when your orchid doesn't have any more space for new growth, practically it outgrows its pot. Now, this is a lot more common with sympodial orchids such as Oncidiums, Cattleyas, Dendrobiums, and so on, orchids that usually produce pseudobulbs or canes, since they do grow along a rhizome. And at some point, they will grow so large that there will be no more space in the pot for new growth. This is definitely a cue to repot your orchid, maybe in a bigger pot, or you can always opt for shrinking a little bit the orchid. And if you don't know what I'm talking about, I will definitely link you down below to the video that I made a while back, in which I tell you how I managed to keep my collection tiny, but not in numbers, just in size. So you can definitely work a little bit with the size of your orchid or keep it as it is. But when you have orchids growing their roots totally outside the pot and you are a home grower, that is definitely a sign that you should think about repotting. Because the problem is the new roots will not benefit from the moisture provided for the medium. And again, typically in homes, you will just not have enough humidity to support those aerial roots properly, or you just won't have time to mist them properly and hydrate the entire orchid through those new roots. And in time, the older roots will not be so efficient at absorbing water and nutrients as the newer roots. And if the new roots are outside of the pot, you can actually experience some dehydration. Now, in these cases, of course, your environment plays a really big role, but typically speaking, if you are a windowsill grower, you should definitely address any orchid which starts to grow outside of the pot. Because in no time, you might actually have quite the hard time keeping your orchid properly hydrated. Now, with monopodials such as Phalaenopsis, Vandas, and other orchids, obviously you will not have pseudobulbs or canes outgrowing the pot, but you can have instances in which the roots absolutely take over the pot. Practically, you will see a mass of roots in the pot rather than medium, case in which your orchid will not suffer. None of these orchids will, since most of them are epiphytic orchids. They grow in the air naturally, but you will start to have a much harder time keeping your orchids hydrated, which indirectly will affect them as well, because they will start to become more and more dehydrated due to maybe your lack of time, which is super common for home growers. I cannot really stay on top of watering sometimes as well. Typically, an outgrown orchid means less hydration for the orchid and a harder time for you, so it is time to repot an orchid, either in a larger pot, either divide it and put it back in the same pot, making sure that it has enough room in the pot to grow at least about 2 years. Second instance, and this is one that I believe not many people talk about, when your orchid dries way, way too fast. I'm talking about every day or every other day or even every 3 days. That's a little bit too fast if you're a windowsill grower. And this can happen to both sympodial orchids such as Oncidiums and Cattleyas and Dendrobiums, and also monopodials, as I was saying. Now, orchids, even though similar between them, they do have their own little quirks. And you can actually have an orchid which is a massive root producer. So you will not have a lot going on the surface, but you can end up having a massive root system in the pot. So you might be tempted to place the orchid in a pretty tiny pot that goes to what you see on top of it, which will get full of roots in no time. I'm talking about months. Oncidium Cherry Baby, the Twinkles, some Brassia hybrids. These are very well known massive root producers. And sometimes you can find yourself in a position of not having enough time to keep up with the watering demands of your orchid. Again, in this instance, you might want to consider repotting an orchid, changing the pot size or the material inside the pot. Something needs to help you out with that water retention. So either you're gonna make a mixture with a little bit more moss, or you are going to provide a ventilated bigger pot. The end result should be an easier time with watering your orchid. So definitely, if you find that your orchid simply drinks up that water way too fast, lightning fast, which by the way, it's okay if you have time to keep up with the watering, that's absolutely fine. But if you don't have time, it is perfectly fine to consider repotting. Because again, in the end, if you don't have time to properly water your orchid, that will just affect the overall health of your orchid as well. Next instance is medium degradation. If you're using organic media such as bark and sphagnum moss, in time they will break down. Since they're organic, they will start to degrade. And this is especially common with brand new orchids. The orchids we usually purchase from stores have been in that medium for at least a year or two. So practically, you're purchasing an orchid with an already older medium, which is absolutely fine, but it also means that you have to pay attention to the signs of breaking down medium. And what I'm showing you is quite the old medium in here. First off, it smells bad, really, really bad. It can range from a chemical sort of smell to a very, very pungent, mushroomy smell, especially if it's accompanied by visual cues such as literal mushrooms or fungal growth inside. That is definitely a sign that you need to repot the orchid, get rid of all of this old medium, put it in the compost pile or in the garden, and provide fresh new medium for your orchid. Broken down bark is not rigid anymore, and if you try to break it in between your fingers, you will easily do so. It will crumble to a sort of dusty-like texture. It's not going to maintain its shape, and obviously because of that, it will not provide aeration for the orchid. So, a broken down, degraded medium not only has the potential to suffocate the root system, but also damage it chemically speaking. When it's breaking down, the medium becomes more and more acidic. It can reach to such low levels that it will start to literally burn the roots. Excess algae or fungal growth can actually release byproducts which will affect the roots as well. You can smell a broken down medium, particularly after you water it. Fresh new medium typically smells like pine bark pretty much, but broken down medium has a very, very awful scent which is hard to describe. But just looking at what I'm showing you here, I think you can have an idea of what it can smell like. And it's really, really powerful. So if you see something like this on your orchid, it is time to repot as soon as possible. Next instance, which tells you need to repot the orchid, is pests in the medium or a fungal outbreak. This can happen in fresh new medium as well. If it's either bad quality medium, either it hasn't been stored properly, and actually experienced this quite recently with one of my orchids. I stored the bark chips outside on the terrace, and somehow a fungus spore managed to make its way in, developed, and all of the orchids repotted in that medium had fungal outbreaks, and they were not pretty. The orchids inside of those pots, and actually plants, did not do well at all. It was such a big outbreak that no amount of hydrogen peroxide actually fixed it, so the best solution was to completely remove all of that medium, dispose of it, and offer fresh new medium. In the case of pests, well, sadly, there are some insects which manage or like to burrow inside the medium. Mealybugs are one of them, but not only, bush snails like to live inside the medium as well. And typically, when we are treating pests, it is a good idea to make sure that we are treating the entirety of the orchid. If we're dealing with a pest that is known to actually burrow in the root zone, it is a great idea to unpot that orchid, maybe get rid of the medium, spray with whatever we want to spray the base and the roots of the orchid, and offer fresh new medium. Now, I do have a video on the most common pests in the orchid hobby. I will link you to it down below in the description, but definitely having pests inside the medium and having no means of getting rid of them without accessing the roots or getting rid of the medium is definitely a very, very good reason to repot. Next instance is when the pot or the medium is totally not suited for that particular orchid or for your caring conditions. So I'll give you some examples here. I have a Tulumnia orchid in a clay pot. This is an unglazed clay pot. Compared to a plastic pot of roughly the same size, a clay pot will always dry faster because it is very porous and water evaporates super fast from it. Now, this can be a good thing or a bad thing. In environments that are rather cooler or more humid, you may actually benefit from faster evaporation. And for you, an orchid like this can dry out pretty slow. But in other environments, which might be hotter or drier, you may find that a clay pot dries out way too fast, faster than your time permits to water your orchids. Hence, you might actually want to go for a plastic pot, which can retain more water. Also, the type of medium, as I was saying, bark chips are very airy and retain very little water, but sphagnum moss retains a lot more water. If your orchid simply dries out way too slow or way too fast for your preference and your possibilities, that definitely is a strong reason for you to repot an orchid into a more suitable pot or medium. You don't have to keep an orchid in the same pot or the same type of medium you purchased it in. Nurseries have very different conditions than home growers. Typically, they have a lot of air movement, they have automatic watering, they can water just like that, whenever they feel like it. You might have a job, a family to take care of, pets. You know what I'm talking about. You might have a lot of stuff that you have to do. The last thing you want to do is water your orchid two times a day, right? Adjusting the pot or the pot size, adjusting the medium, and all of these tiny little customizations you can absolutely do are super good reasons for you to repot an orchid. So even if your orchid is freshly potted, don't feel bad about it. The most important thing is for you to be comfortable, because this will actually help you better take care of your orchid. So if you're not happy with the pot you have or the medium you have, just repot your orchid. It's that simple. And lastly, when you have a lot of dead roots inside the pot. This is very common when you repot newer orchids, especially if they're coming from very different conditions than yours. They can actually go into transplant shock, and the roots they come with might not actually adapt to your new environment, your new medium, and so on. And the result of that is dead roots. So you could have a brand new orchid repotted into fresh medium after a month, starting to smell super bad because the roots inside are dead. Definitely, you need to go back in and re-repot the orchid. What you need to do is remove the orchid from the pot, cut away all of the dead roots, and if you can, reuse the medium you used. But if it's very affected by the dying roots, you can definitely opt for fresh new medium. Most of the times, it is actually possible to reuse the medium, which is great because you're not wasting it. But definitely, if your freshly repotted orchid starts to smell bad, especially after watering, there's something going on in the medium. My guess is you have a lot of dead roots that you need to absolutely remove, because all they will do is spoil the fresh new medium, make it degrade super fast, and in the end affect the brand new roots that will grow on your orchid. So that makes it a super valid reason for you to repot the orchid, even if you're gonna reuse the medium. Now, as I was saying, I do have a few notes on repotting in general that I would like to end the video with, starting with transplant shock, since I just talked about it. It is common sometimes that orchid will not adapt all that easily to a new medium or a new environment. So I do have a video in which I talk more about how to ease this transition if it's happening, or what factors actually affect or make transplant shock more likely. So I'll be sure to link you to that video down below in the description. So just keep in mind that if you repot an orchid and suddenly it loses all of its roots, it happens. It is transplant shock. Some orchids go through it, some orchids don't, and there are ways in which you can make the transition just a little bit easier. Also, repotting orchids in bloom, not necessarily the greatest idea because you might actually damage some of the roots and that can make the orchid just give up its buds and its blooms. So typically, if an orchid is in bloom, it is best to wait a little bit if you can, just postpone repotting. But if you cannot, if the medium is so broken down that the roots are being burned, if you have a lot of pests inside the medium, then we need to prioritize the health of the orchid, not the flowers. However, if it's just maintenance repotting or the orchid is just starting to outgrow its pod, maybe you can wait just a little more if you want to enjoy the blooms. And lastly, should you repot an orchid directly after you purchase it? Again, depends on the orchid. Sometimes orchid media is not all that broken down. You may not see any pest or any reason to think there are some pests in the medium. So you could actually maintain your orchid in the same pot for a month or so, just enjoy the blooms and then repot it. But of course, if you see that there's something very, very wrong with your orchid, definitely repot it the moment you bring it home, if that's what you think is best. But honestly, most of the times, I myself keep brand new orchids, maybe about 2 weeks to a month or so, in the medium they come with before I repot them. Alrighty guys, so that has been it for today's video. I hope you've enjoyed it and I hope you learned something new. Thank you all so, so much for watching and thank you RepotMe for sponsoring yet another episode of our Orchid Care for Beginners series. Remember, you have links to more information down below in the description and more tutorials. In this series, we talked about a lot of beginner-friendly subjects, so do feel free to check out the entire playlist. Subscribe to my channel for more orchid videos, tutorials, experiments, updates, and other fun orchid subjects. If you wish to support the channel, do consider becoming a member or visit the merch store linked down below in the description. You can also follow me on Instagram and Facebook. It's always nice to stay in touch there as well. And I'll see you next time. Bye!